Acts chapter 2 needs to be relived when we, the church, are done being timid, sleeves rolled up, knelt knees, dirty with dust, faces covered with every ocean drop, lips drenched in midnight prayer as they are salt and water, healed and cleansed land. You could tell by the furnace burning in their eyes that God had answered their cries, and now their bones had ignited into fire, burning as hell. And so each time they moved, it gave the enemy a taste of home. In this beat, they wouldn't stop. In this heat, they wouldn't stop. Their sweat was as heavy as thunder, seeking to redeem the joy the enemy had plundered. Because once they were broken and bruised, silently hidden behind church walls. Oh, but now they were confident blacksmiths, molting his word, God, sharper than a two-edged sword, down their spine so that they could stand strong, tall, bold, ready to fight, address principalities as they dressed in Ephesians 6:11. Girls and boys with swords who understand that this is war. So set the foxes on fire, Samson, and let's pay the enemy's fields and camp a visit. We will arrive as a burning bush, an exodus igniting lightning sea, vutsumlila malangabi, so that even when we are dead and buried, the earth and future won't despise and forget our bones as holy friction, not just fiction, as us dust collides with the chief cornerstone. Now it's lava, explosion of scriptures, faith fumes, worship consumes, goba ungumlilo qothulayo yebo uka shula izibopho. And that's why the fields of the enemy are black with soot of shame and defeat, because no fire goes unseen. Though long done, the evidence is imminent, and that's why the three Hebrew boys could parade in fire, because the fourth man was infinite degrees immeasurable. And so, even after 7 times 7 heat turned up, he, Omega, the multiplication exponentially, the expert, walked in with world-class information. Did you know that? The sun is 109 times bigger than the earth and burns at 15 million degrees Celsius. So, King Nebuchadnezzar, what business brings you here? Can't you see that you are dealing with fire himself? See, he is dressed in fire. The all-consuming fire could lick up the rivers and ocean if it pleased him, yet he placed the sun at a great distance enough for us to just merely bask beneath it. Rule forever, O king, but don't be fooled. Don't be fooled, O child of God. Let it be known that you are flammable. Yes, you are flames. So, set the foxes on fire, Samson, and let's pay the enemy's fields and camp a visit. We will take back everything that the enemy stole from us and tear down all the strongholds as we ignite.